Subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications. Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see what are the most effective 15 days plan for JEE Mains. So if you follow this study plan, I'm sure you're going to get very good score in JEE Mains. So in this video, we are also going to see what is the cutoff, what are the standard books and like marks versus rank, that is for how many marks, how much rank you're going to get, JEE Mains exam postponed. All these details we are going to look in this video. So make sure you watch this video till the end. And so now let's begin this video without any delay. To the day one, from today one, from morning 5 a.m. to 7 a.m., you need to study magnetics. Okay, magnetics is one of the most important chapter coming to physics. And take a short break from 7 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. and 8:30 a.m. you need to again resume back to your studies and continue with the same magnetics chapter. Okay, 12:30 to 2:30 p.m. you need to start studying chemistry chapter, which is atomic structure. Okay, and take a small break again, and from 3:30 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. continue studying atomic structure. Okay, and coming to 7 p.m. to 10 p.m. three-dimensional geometry. Okay, day two, in this timings you need to start studying from optics, and in this timings of day two prepare electrochemistry, and in day two from 7 to 10 p.m. start studying vectors. Okay, coming to day 3 plan, in this timings you need to concentrate on modern physics, and coming to chemistry you need to concentrate on chemical kinetics, and to mathematics in day 3 you need to concentrate on sequence and series. Day 4 under physics you need to cover electromagnetic induction and alternating current. Okay, and coming to day 4 chemistry, gaseous and liquid state is one of the most important chapter. Coming to day 4 mathematics, you need to cover straight line. Coming to day 5, this is your chapter which you need to cover in this timings, and you need to cover nuclear and surface chemistry under chemistry, and determinant and matrices under mathematics in day 5. In day 6 under physics you need to cover electrostatics. This is also one of the most important chapter where multiple questions will be asked from this particular chapter. And coming to day 6 chemistry, covered the chapter chemical bonding, and coming to mathematics in this particular timings of day 6 you need to cover circle. And coming to day 7 under physics you need to cover current, electricity, and under chemistry you need to cover P block elements as well as D block elements. And coming to mathematics you need to cover complex numbers. Okay, and coming to day 8, this is your syllabus. All these three chapters you need to cover on day 3 within these timings. And coming to day 9, this is your syllabus which you need to cover. Okay, semiconductors under physics, aromatic compounds under chemistry, functions under mathematics. Okay, and coming to day 10, kinematics under physics, thermodynamics under chemistry, limits, continuity and differentiability under mathematics. I'll also give you the whole picture of the timetable. Bohr's atomic model is very, very much important. And coming to day 11 chemistry, you need to cover isomerism and probability distribution under mathematics. Okay, so coming to day 12, you need to cover the chapter waves and sound. Day 12, this is your syllabus. To day 13, properties of matter, carboxylic acids and its derivatives and binomial theorem, you need to cover under day 13. Okay, and coming to day 14, you need to cover gravitation, general organic chemistry, height and distance. To day 15, you can clearly see that two cells are blank. Okay, in these particular timings you can just revise the concepts or the chapters in which you are not so confident or yet. Okay, so use this particular timings for revision in mathematics. Trigonometric ratio and functions are very much important. So now you can just take a quick screenshot of the schedule. After this we are going to see what are the standard books for JEE mains and what are the tips and tricks in going to see what is the cutoff. Also going to see the latest update of JEE mains exam postponement or cancellation. Now let's see what are the standard and best books for JEE mains. Okay, so coming to physics, while preparation or during exam, it's always good to have a time management. Okay, so because there will be a lot more questions and limited time, so most of the students will be running out of the time. So in order to avoid such kind of situation, it's always good to manage your time. Okay, so once the exam begins, just quickly start solving the easy questions and then start solving the tough questions. It will help you to manage the time during the exam. Please stick to the study plan. The study plan which I have given, stick to it, because if you follow that, you can easily get a great score coming to your JEE mains. Next is mock tests. Start attempting mock tests so that you will understand how much time you're taking to solve a question out of your mistakes. Okay, so whatever mistakes you're making while mock test, just make a note of that and make sure you don't repeat them during your final exam. Okay, refer to previous papers. What is the advantage of referring to the previous papers is you will understand how is the paper, and 40 to 50% of similar questions will be asked every year from the previous paper. So it's always better to refer to the previous year's papers. Okay, so next is revise daily. Okay, so whatever you are studying for the whole day, for 1 hour before sleeping, just revise them every day. Revise them daily, so that what is the advantage is when you revise the things on the same day, you tend to remember them for long time and you can easily memorize them in your exams. Okay, so next is don't allot too much time for single topic. Few students will stick to single topic and they read the same chapter for the whole day. No, not be the case, because you have really limited time for your exam. So no negative marking in JEE means you don't have any kind of negative marking. So don't leave any answer blank. Don't leave any question blank, because you have no negative marking. It's always good to put one or the other answer which is at least related to the question instead of leaving that. Okay. So next is clear your doubts immediately. Whatever doubts you get on the very same day, it's suggested to clear all of them. Okay. So next is don't refer too many books. Most of the students for single subject, they'll be referring multiple books. So what happens is, instead of gaining the concept, in return they'll be confused. Okay. So it's better not to follow too many books just for a single subject. Okay, so stay away from distractions at least for these few days. No, be in a silent and peaceful place. Whatever you study, if you study in a silent place, the concept will directly go into your brain. Okay, and always make sure you start studying from the early hours. Start compare with others. Example, few students will give mock tests and they'll compare the result with their friends. If their friends or classmates gets more marks, they'll start panicking, start losing confidence. So that's why it's suggested not to compare with your friends. Okay, whatever you did your best, and whatever you do, you are going to give your best. Okay, so just be confident. Okay, So next is make a note of important formulae. Mathematics and coming to physics, whatever formula you feel as important, just note down in a small book so that just before the exam also you can just have a look into the book. And every day while revising also it will be helpful for you. Eat healthy and exercise. B means marks versus rank. Okay. Now coming to $1,000 question. Minister told that they are still analyzing the situation and they didn't decide anything. They didn't come to any conclusion. So most of the students are wasting the present time by thinking about the future. Just prepare yourself that exam is there and it's going to be conducted on time. Make sure you stick to the study plan. Make sure you complete your syllabus and do your level best. Okay, now you just need to concentrate on your studies, give your exam well and get a good score. Okay, that's all you need to think about. So yeah, that's it for today folks. All the very best for your exam and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you will be notified whenever I make a new video. And share this video so that I'll be giving you more and more such kind of updates.